Do you want to go for his propulsion? I mean, let's say he's got two hover blades left and a lot of other stuff, but he actually wants to move away, and you know you've got a healer behind you. If you just go for the hover blade, he can't run away after that. He will just stand still, and then you kill him. And if he takes some damage, it doesn't matter because you've got the healer behind you. So there are always different options. Most of it is just common sense. And at the end, you won't probably be in a gunfight and be like, what did that guy in the tutorial say? Let's remember about that. Let's have a plan. Let's write that down. And you just go for it anyway. But maybe sometime in the fight, try to use your brain a little bit and, or reflect afterwards. Would it be better if I went for that instead of that? Won't hurt you. SMTs, I do have one. I suck. I don't want to have any comments on my SMG. I know it's far from perfect. SMGs, you want to have more guns than you need because you are actually the only one who really wants to go into the front line. You want to go in. You want to battle. You are a Klingon. Because you are a Klingon, you want to have redundancy, you want to have a few guns more. So if you lose a few guns, you still have a few guns. You want to have a lot of blocks. If you lose a few blocks, you still have a lot of blocks. You get the picture, you're a Klingon. So yeah, SMG gun bear, typically 10 guns, 12 guns, whatever. Have a lot of guns left, even if you lose a few. Burst fire if the enemy is in the distance. Spray and pray if you're getting close by. Maybe try to rotate a little bit, always know where your guns are, so actually all of your guns are firing. Don't have a gun in the back. See a lot of people having guns there and there, because then you can fire when the enemy is behind you. Well, I tell you what, if you have guns back here, let's say I lost a few guns, so I only have like 4 guns left, so let's say only 1, 2, 3, 4. I lost that one, lost that one, lost that one. And I think I have a few at the bottom. Yes, I lost those as well. But I still have 2 guns in the back. Yeah, great. What am I supposed to do now? I'm still shooting at the enemy. I've got 6 guns firing. Of the 6 guns firing, 2 are just firing myself in the ass. Of course, they don't deal damage to me, but they don't deal damage to the enemy either. You always want all of your guns to be able to hit the enemy. If you don't do that, you will just decrease your damage output. So even if I have 10 guns, if I add another 2 on my back, it will mean instead of 10 guns which are firing at a rate which is the same as 6 guns, so if I have 10 guns and they are all firing and all can actually hit the enemy, I will deal damage as if I was firing at the enemy with 6 guns. If, however, I will now add 2 guns in the back, I know I don't have a CPU for that, just imagine I add 2 guns in the back. Now I don't have 10 guns firing, I have 12 firing, but 2 of them will never hit. So now I have a damage decrease of 16%, meaning I deal damage as if I was using 5 guns. What? I add guns and I lose damage. Yes, you do. Even if you are an SMG gun bad, please position all your guns in a manner that they can all theoretically hit the enemy if he is in front of you. Maybe there is some kind of French tank design where you actually want to fire while the enemy is behind you and you're running away, don't know about that. I have seen gun bads which are constructed in a way that they are always shooting sideways, so you're actually driving around the enemy and you're all firing to the side. You at least want to be able to do that, so maybe my front SMGs are not really a good idea. I'm testing that for now, not sure on whether or not I should keep that. But yes, you want all your guns to be able to fire at the same time, you want to have redundant guns, and you want to be able to still move around and deal some damage when you are really low. So if you're at 40% and you still have 2 guns left and can still move and fire the enemy, you've done it right. If you are at 90% and you've got problems because you've lost one thruster, you're not doing it right. For example, maybe it would be a good idea if I didn't have two thrusters, but only one thruster in the middle. So if I have this thruster, I'm moving. If I lose it, I'm still moving fine. With the setup I've got right now, if I lose one side thruster, I only have the other left. And when I press forward, I go in circuits. Maybe not a good idea. I will have to rethink the design when it comes to my two thrusters. Quite sure I should go down to one or even none at all. Maybe have another hover blade on the back and the middle instead, or whatever. What you definitely don't want to have is like two thrusters right in the middle on the side, on and two thrusters again right in the middle on the other side, because then you will lose it very, very soon. I mean, my thrusters are kind of hidden, are kind of behind the guns. They don't die that easily, but if I have them really on the outside, if I was to place my thruster here, first of all, it would have a lot more leverage because it's on the side. Second, I would lose it very, very early. And if I have one here and I lose it, and I have one on the other side and I haven't lost it yet, I will go on circuits all the time. Don't do that. And that's roughly all I have to say about SMGs for now. What else did I talk about? Actually, I have to have a drink now. We do still have wheels and legs. Yeah, well, wheels, been talking about that before. 4 may not be the best number. I like 6, 8 is a good number to have as well. Wheels do have advantages and disadvantages. If you ever try to build a hover, you know what I'm talking about. Wheels are just very easy to place. You just put them at the bottom somewhere and you're fine. Hovers, however, you put them somewhere in the middle and then you craft toggles or whatever. You can't really put on thrusters everywhere, because if you lose a few thrusters, you only need to go in circuits. If you take damage, maybe you lose a hover blade quite early, but didn't lose a lot of stuff around that. You will be hanging in the air like that, and when you're half dead, you can't move at all. Oh, it's a pain in the ass. Wheels are just very easy to handle, hard to hit. They're just down there and they work. That's what they do. They do their job and nothing else. Of course, against plasmas, it's a great idea to be hovering, because for plasma, it's easy to hit someone who's on the ground. It's a bit harder to hit a hover, because if you miss and only hit the ground, the wheeler will still take damage, the hover doesn't. But the wheel, I mean, it's got a very low CPU load, a high armor for the size of it. The armor of wheels is huge if you have a look at the hitbox of them. And everything above the wheels you can just use for armor and stuff. However, if you have hovers, you want the hovers to be above the center of gravity. However, usually you want to have everything on the top, so you want to have the guns on top. You want to have a lot of blocks to protect all the guns on top. You want to have gun mounts for the guns on top. You want your pilot seat, and you want a roof above the pilot seat on top. You want everything on top, and on top of having everything on top, you want your hover blades to be at the top as well. And what do you want to put at the bottom? Nothing. So when you build with hovers, it's always a bit harder, and you really have to make some sacrifices when you build with a hover, or you've just done it 10 times already and scrap it and rebuild and scrap it and rebuild it. Every time you are a little bit smarter, and then you finally figure out how to do it in an almost good way. So yes, that happened with my hover. Some other people may have done it a bit faster. It took me a few attempts to actually have it kind of working the way it is now. But yeah, wheels, you just never have problems with wheels. Only problem is they are on the ground, and when plasmas shoot you, you will just lose them eventually. Wheels again, no, legs. I've been talking about legs before. When you build with legs, what you want to have is, please have some meat on. So you want to have a nice number of blocks, actually. And please have your pilot seat somewhere where your legs are not. I mean, the amount of blocks between my leg and my pilot seat, which is somewhere in there, it's not that big. It's good, it's alright. And I do have a lot of blocks in there. And for the amount of thrusters I had to fit in here, I think I am quite meaty. So it's not perfect. I probably will rebuild it again, but it's alright. I do have some good space there between the leg and the pilot seat, and there's not a direct ray, so the damage actually has to travel round somehow, either through that huge gun mount tit I got on there, or on the other side, and there are a lot of other blocks. So yes, no matter how often you shoot off my leg, my pilot seat doesn't really care. And you will want to have that on your craft as well. Then 4 is not a good number. I've got 4, I would definitely say try to go with 6 legs, not with 4. Maybe you have a CPU problem if you're leveling up and you're like whatever level 25 and already tier 5, really want to have crawler legs. You may have a problem with the amount of CPU you got. Then again, you would have to go for 4 legs. 6 legs means you need a huge craft. But when you go for 4 legs, please be meaty, please have a lot of armor blocks. So when you meet a railer and the railer just goes for your legs to cripple you and to leave you dying for the bombers to pick you up, the vultures, you don't want to die instantly just because someone takes 2 legs off you. And I've mentioned it many times before, only use legs if you really, really want to utilize them. Legs are not good. Legs are great because you can move everywhere you want to. Other than that, legs are shit. Don't go for legs if you could do the same thing with wheels. Don't go for legs if you're only on the ground anyway. And if you are using legs and you feel, oh, I am a bit slow, thrusters won't help you. If you're not jumping, thrusters will not increase your walk speed. They may in a tiny bit, but it's just not worth it. Don't have legs and a huge amount of thrusters on that. If you want to see, I actually think I'm gonna demonstrate that on my stream later on. Just have a look how it looks having like 4 legs and 20 thrusters. But it's not really working in a way that it is with wheels. You use wheels and thrusters, you're really fast. If you're crawling, use thrusters, not really hard. So yeah, fuck legs. Hovers and flights. Hovers again, as I mentioned before, you want them to be on top, and you want everything else to be on top as well. So how do you do it? First of all, hovers are often victims to belly shots against railers. It doesn't happen often that I've got a wheeler against me and I'd be like, oh, I can take a belly shot, there we go. No, that's the hovers. Often when I'm on the ground and the other one is a bit up and he's going to the cliff so he can shoot down on me, he's just exposing his belly, or he's half dead hanging there in the air next to the healer, and it's just 2 men standing there, so I want to kill him. He's got a lot of guns left, he's often exposing his belly. So yeah, you really want to have 2 rows of blocks under your pilot seat. My pilot seat is in here, so yeah, my pilot seat sits on that block. I've got only 1 row of blocks beneath that. I do have some extra belly protection there. I don't know how well it works. So yeah, I have to go 4 down, I think. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, and below that is my driver's seat. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So my driver's seat is on that row. So it's in here. You still want to have them quite on top. So yeah, I've got them in this row. I've got them in here. Here I think it's 1 higher already, somewhere in the middle, and 1 here as well. So the average height is like roughly, yeah, the average height is about here. So I do have more on top compared to on the bottom. if you still are looking for stuff to put on your bottom, you will actually, when you build a hover, you sometimes be like, what else can I do on the bottom? Well, have guns on your bottom.